I'm Henny Espinosa, and this is your TFC News Now.
We begin with this video of a storm researcher's plane flying into the eye of Hurricane Helene as it gathers crucial data on the storm that's forecast to make landfall in Florida's Panhandle Thursday evening as a Category 4 storm, backing sustained wind speeds of up to 156 miles per hour. Officials urged residents in coastal areas along the hurricane's path to evacuate ahead of catastrophic winds and a potentially deadly storm surge that could rise up to 20 feet in some spots. Florida Filipinos are bracing for Helene's impact by making sure their homes are secured and they're ready to flee for safety.
Water, 1 gallon per person per day, at the very minimum, right? For 3 days, worth of food, batteries, flashlight, of course, when there's no power, first aid kit, cell phone with alternative backup charger, you know, and if you're in a flooding zone or flood prone area, then you should have a whistle just in case you need to evacuate.
Yung kotse puno ng ano, puno na ng gas. Tapos sa nilagay na sa garahe. Then yung mga maleta namin, nandun na yung mga lahat ng paperwork ng insurance, life insurance, burial insurance, nakalagay na lahat doon.
Today we are announcing campaign finance, bribery, and conspiracy charges against Eric Adams, the mayor.
In other news, New York City Mayor Eric Adams has been slammed with 5 federal corruption charges. On Thursday, the Southern District Court unsealed a 57-page indictment alleging that the mayor accepted illegal campaign money and over $100,000 in travel benefits, including luxury hotel stays and dining at high-end restaurants, from Turkish government officials. In exchange for the alleged bribes, Adams allegedly pressured city officials to waive safety inspections to allow the opening of a new 36-story Turkish consulate building. The 64-year-old Democrat denied any wrongdoing and dismissed calls for resignation, saying he would fight the charges. Fil-Am Democratic leader Lloyd Nicholas Lewis issued a statement to ABS-CBN News, pointing out that the Constitution guarantees that a person indicted is presumed innocent until proven guilty beyond reasonable doubt, and that Mayor Adams should be accorded the same protection. And finally, we head to San Pedro, California, where thousands flocked to celebrate the 30th edition of the Festival of Philippine Arts and Culture, also known as FPAC. After celebrating 19 of the festivals in Point Fermin Park in San Pedro, FPAC had been moving around for the past decade before finally returning to where it all began.
FPAC has always been a place where community can gather and to be able to continue the legacy of the organization. It's our 30th year this year.
FPAC featured a star-studded lineup including Manila Luzon, Joe Bataan, VST and Company, Ruby Ibarra's Bolo Music Group, as well as Jake Zyrus and Chessa.
And those are the news making headlines today. You can catch more TFC News on the ABS-CBN News website and YouTube channel. I'm Henny Espinosa. Stay with us, Kapamilya.